So good afternoon, everyone. So as was already introduced, my name is Jouni Pullinen, and I'm from Finnish Meteorological Institute. And I will discuss about the same issue about meteorology and how there is especially a lack of observations in this case. As you can understand, in case of weather forecasting, it is very important to have a dense set of stations that are reporting all the time what are the current situation. And this is not only the case for the Arctic weather prediction, because all the events that happen in Arctic, they are also influencing the mid-latitudes. So it is a question that evolves into big amount of people in that way, so what we are doing in the Arctic. What you can see in the view graph over here is basically the weather observations in the Arctic. As you can see, these normal stations, they are located very sparsely. In this region of observations, there is about that dense network of meteorological observation that is basically needed for making proper weather forecasts. And because of this, the satellites are pretty much the only meaningful way of getting that kind of information. Another thing is that there are also stations that are reporting on the weather-related phenomena and other things, but in that case, they are not that much operational, and again, the network is sparse. And so the information which is available through these terrestrial stations is not enough. And what is then needed is pretty much satellite systems. This is shown in this view graph. So this is only a partial picture showing the equator-passing geosynchronous satellites, which are over the equator. And they are very important regarding meteorological applications, because they provide all-time observations, for example, regarding how the clouds are moving, and that is very essential. But the handicap is that they do not cover high latitudes. And because of that, there are also, or there are some other reasons as well, but there are polar orbiting satellites which are providing data that is feasible also for polar regions, but they do not have a permanent coverage. You can assemble information from many satellites that are going from pole to pole, and thereby that you can make some products, for example, regarding polar winds, as NOAA in the USA is doing. They are gathering all the data from several polar orbiting satellites and make an analysis of that in order to have the information that the numerical weather prediction is needed. But that is not enough. There is also needed continuous kind of monitoring, and there has been some proposals to make kind of elliptical orbit imagers, which are in so-called Molniya orbit, going very up high in the pole, north, above the North Pole, and staying for a long time in the altitude of 40,000 kilometers, and have that kind of monitoring, what is available for the equatorial plane as well. But there are unfortunately only plans for that kind of things. So Russians are pretty much thinking about building, but I guess there are some financial things. Then Canadians have had that kind of plans, but probably it's not going to have these meteorological applications. So in general, we are going to have this problem of sparse observations in the high latitudes in the future as well, even though new emerging satellite systems are helping in that. Then last, there are also kind of things that we are in Finland doing regarding ice and weather monitoring in the Arctic Sea. And that is something what we are going to demonstrate for the chairmanship of Finland in the Arctic Council for the coming years. So how to provide weather and sea ice information for the vessels that are cruising in the Arctic. And we are having that kind of demonstration systems under progress in Finland, and that is something happening in that as well. But I would like to stress that there remains this kind of handicap in the high latitudes in the future as well. Okay, thank you.